Before moving on further in the module, let's take a look at some examples of data visualization. These visualizations come from different sources, including the web and news media, mostly newspapers. Most of the examples are not ideal data visualizations and can be improved upon in many different ways. As I show those examples, it would be helpful for you to think about the good and the bad about each of the graphs. We will come back to many of those examples later in the module to use them as context for our discussion. This video is based on a Beyond.com survey. It illustrated the gap between how millennials describe themselves and how HR professionals describe them. At first sight, this video is quite interesting, but can you spot any issues with it? Your first instinct would probably be to read it as part of a whole, but clearly the percentages don't add up to 100%, so the shading can't be based on percentage of the sticker figure's surface area. This might mean it's based on height or distance, similar to a map legend. For instance, a half inch would equal 1%, but even that is ambiguous, because how tall is this sticker figure really? The shading might be completely arbitrary and gets especially confusing when the visualization splits up the shading. In addition to all of this, there are also typed comments, the purpose and effect of which is completely unclear. Does it make the message more compelling? This graph is a 3D bar graph for the worldwide revenue of the analytics company SAS and its research and development spending. Can you suggest any improvement? What about this one? This graph represents where your tax dollars would go and to see what portion of the federal budget is dedicated to different program areas under President Obama's proposed budget for 2016. The original video is found on the official White House website. This type of graph is called a tree map. The main challenge with this graph is that comparison is very difficult. In order to compare two figures, we need to compare the areas of two rectangles, which is not easy for most people. It is also unclear whether there is any meaning to the coloring scheme either. This visualization is from the USA Today website. Do you know what type of graph it is? When I first looked at it, it took me 10 seconds to figure out that the graphic was a line graph. My eyes immediately went to the picture of the house. Placing a picture of a house on top of the graph makes the boundaries of the graph difficult to discern, especially since they are similar in color to the house. The data increment lines on the y-axis even go beyond the house. It would have been helpful to use a different color for the x and y-axis increments and lines. Additionally, it remains unclear as to why the house changes color above the trend line. Finally, without a description in the upper left color, this graph is meaningless. Neither the x-axis nor the y-axis are labeled with titles or have units. The x-axis could be determined to be years without a description, but the y-axis remains unclear. Overall, this data visualization needs to be redesigned to better convey its message. This is an interesting example of a bad visualization which was created on purpose by the America's United for Life as a propaganda piece against Planned Parenthood. Can you spot any issues with the graph? We will discuss this graph in a little more details later.